Hello, everybody, and welcome to Tasha's Take, the Fashion of the Bachelorette. Here we are. It's the finale already. Can you believe we did 10 of these
things? Oh, my gosh. It just flew by.
Yeah, it really did. Anyway, I'm Tasha Courtney. This is my fiancé, Dave Neal.
Hi,
and
how are you?
We are here today talking about all the fashion from the Bachelorette.
Cheers.
From the season finale. Oops.
Don't watch that microphone.
Episode 10. I've obviously been drinking wine already.
We got our Spade and Sparrow. Kaitlyn Bristowe's
wine. Yeah.
Very nice.
Give a little free advertising here. Not a sponsor. But if you want to sponsor us, we're down.
Yeah, send us a crate.
But yeah, so we're going to be talking today about all the fashion from episode 10 and after the final rose. We had some really, really beautiful dresses. We had some fun casual outfits. Here's the first one.
So we're going to end with the after the final rose outfits. We'll start with,
we'll go chronologically. Yeah, I think it makes sense. So we'll try our best to go in chronological order.
Sounds
Unfortunately,
good.
I wasn't really paying too close of attention to chronological order when I put this blog post together. So we might jump around a little bit, but hopefully you guys won't hold that against
me. No worries, honey.
But yeah, first up, we had Blake's one-on-one date, mm-hmm. his daytime date. And I actually wasn't planning to include this shoulder pad t-shirt until one of you guys mentioned that you couldn't wait to hear my take on it. So I decided to throw it in at the last minute. I think my eyes didn't really register that it was a shoulder pad t-shirt until you all mentioned it. But here we are. It's a shoulder pad t-shirt. It is super trendy right now.
Really?
I actually have been fitting shoulder pad t-shirts for a while now. Ever since they first came out, people, like designers, were all about it, thought it was so cool. It makes sense that it comes on the heels of shoulder pads being trendy and things like dresses and blazers, people would decide, okay, we're going to bring back the shoulder pad t-shirt. I don't know that this is necessarily a lasting trend because it is kind of like an odd thing. And
that's closest you're going to get to criticism. That's not a lasting trend.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not saying it's bad. It's a cute look. It's a fun look. It's very trendy.
She looks like a Power Ranger. That's what Power Rangers would wear. That's a Power Ranger outfit there. Pink Power Ranger.
I mean, I'll tell you what. I searched shoulder pad t-shirt on Revolve, and there were probably at least 20 options on sale. The first one I linked was the cheapest option I could find, the $41 little tie-dye clouds version. It's on sale. And then I linked a few other options that were closer to Katie's color palette if you really like the pink color that she's wearing.
Okay.
But, you know, this is something you can find. I didn't look on any of the cheaper sites like Shein, but, you know, it's something that, like, girl, go for it. If you want to be bold, if you want to try a new trend, absolutely do that. This is super fun. It's very of the moment. So I would not discourage anyone from trying it. It is really cute, especially with a little high-waisted jean short or like a high-waisted pant for back to school. This is fun.
This is sexy Steve Jobs.
But, you know, if you don't want to spend $128 on a t-shirt to try this trend, I can understand that because we don't know how long this is going to last.
Yeah.
But the other thing to note is you can probably always take the shoulder pads out of your shirt. Normally when designers make this style, the sleeve is flipped up under the shoulder pad.
So you can tuck it in.
Yeah, and the shoulder pad is sort of hidden in between the layer of t-shirt that's at the shoulder where the shoulder seam is and stuffed in between like a little taco of the actual sleeve. So you could probably clip out the pad and like, you know, do a raw hem on the sleeve or like cut it off if you decided you wanted to change your mind about the look and not waste your money.
Yeah,
now you just have a plain old t-shirt.
That day two of wearing something where you don't have the same confidence. The coffee didn't hit the same way. And you're like, let's not do shoulder pads. All right, what do we have here? Tayshia's jumping into the sunny outfit.
Well, this was actually so, okay, we're definitely going out of order now, but that's okay. This is what Tayshia was wearing when she was showing rings to Blake. So this was actually towards the end of the episode. This outfit didn't get a whole lot of love in the show, but it was teased in a lot of the previews on Instagram earlier this week, and I thought it was so fun and flirty. Immediately when I looked at this outfit, I thought that it was a, hold on, I'm drawing a massive blank right now, either a Farm Rio or a, can you scoot over so I can see what I link, a Tularosa. dress. Tula Rosa is one of Revolve's in-house brands, and they do a lot of stuff like this, like big flowy skirts, lots of like eyelet pattern, and this just totally gave me those vibes. So the first things I searched were Farm Rio and Tula Rosa to try and find dupes, and I think I found some really fun stuff. You're really just looking for lots of volume, big sleeves, big skirt hem. Can you go back to the main picture of Tayshia for me? Yeah, like look at all this detailing. So it's a high neck dress, right? And it's got, this is called a
mock collar, maybe?
Well, now it's so blurry, I can't tell. But it's just got all this detailing here. It's got little like faggoting inset detailing along the sleeve up here. I think it has the same.
What's it called?
Faggoting. It's like little sticks. Like little ladder pattern in your
that's a term that they use?
Yeah, no, this is really what it's called.
Wow.
I don't want to say eyelet, but you know, it's like an embroidery pattern almost. Okay. But you see that little like ladder that's along her collarbone here and then over her chest here and then along the skirt. So all of that is going to give a lot of added texture, a lot of added dimension and detailing. And I love the volume in the sleeves. I think this is so, so fun. This is really fun for summer, but because it has like the long sleeves, you could totally wear this into fall. And yellow is just a popular color, I feel like, right now and on the show. When we're seeing like bright pops of color on these girls, a lot of times it's in this like banana yellow family, and I'm really digging it.
It really shows up on camera, you know. It's a pop. This isn't a background outfit. This is lead center of, you know, they wouldn't put her in this if it was Katie's rose ceremony. You know, this would cause attention.
Although if you scroll up,
oh, did she wear this?
Exactly. Oh, yeah. What Kaitlyn was wearing.
This is really Hunger Games
They have given me Hunger Games vibes this whole season, but I really like it because it just, you know, it reinforces that they are having a lot of fun.
What's this color on the chest? Is it just a pull of happening? What is that?
That's a cowl neck.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, that's a cowl. So basically,
I'm talking about Tayshia.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Tayshia, there, it looks like you can almost see through.
Tayshia's outfit, I believe, is actually a jumpsuit. It's a one piece underneath there with the blazer over it.
Mm.
I actually have. I know you pulled up some
with
shots
with an open back, right?
Yeah.
So let me just, I'll find it. You keep talking about it. Oh, I got it right there.
So yeah, there's the back of Tayshia's jacket, which I hadn't seen this in any of the previous shots. So I just thought she had on a little one piece jumpsuit with a blazer over it. I didn't know that it had all this going on in the back, which is so awesome.
What a weird tan line you'll get.
Well, I don't know if she's worried about her tan line right now. But anyway, back to her main outfit. It's different. You know, of all of the looks, you know, I stand Tayshia. I have loved all of Tayshia's looks this season. Could you just scroll it down a little bit for us? So I can see like their whole outfit. It's just got a lot going on. When I was searching for dupes for this look, I was typing tuxedo as the keyword because she's got tuxedo detailing here. She has the single button at the center front on the jacket. She's got a lot going on, like on the lapel here. You know, it's a shaped, glittery lapel.
It's award ceremony presenter outfit.
Yeah. It's just a lot. It's got a lot of sass. But I did find a couple blazers that gave me the same vibe, and I found a couple one-piece jumpsuits that gave me the same vibe. So if you're looking to try out this look, you definitely can. You know, it's just different. I saw a funny tweet that was like, this is what happens when you don't call each other to say, what are you wearing? Because their outfits don't look like they go. But that's okay.
Hate it when me and the boys don't call each other and find out we're wearing the same t-shirts. What do you think about Kaitlyn here?
I really like Kaitlyn's. Like I said, I'm loving all the yellow. This is a super cute, simple, bias cut dress. It has the asymmetrical cowl neck at the top with this little strap going across her collarbone here. And then the bottom has an asymmetrical hem that kind of makes the same shape as the top.
Do you think that strap is like functionally, like you can do different things with it? Or you think, you know what I mean?
Sometimes
people will take their bikini and they'll put it on one side.
I think her hair is covering it here, but I think it actually has two straps that go like this. And then this single strap is just going to be like tacked here at the corner.
So what's the function of it?
It's not functional. Okay. This is purely decorative. This is purely design intent.
Leave it up to the guys to look for a function. Is that, there's no function here. It's art. All right.
But yeah, it does have, because it's bias cut, it has like a really nice drape over the body. It's just going to like kind of cling over the body. And the cowl neck is just, it's cut at a wider width so that when it sits where it's supposed to on your chest, it drapes in the middle. And it's just really nice and subtle. Makes all girls look good. I love any chest.
Notice their hands. They look like they just finished a cheerleading move, you know, when you put your okay.
Well, this is a promotional photo, so the set photographer is like, hey guys, let's get a pic of your outfits, and they're just like, okay, they're just ready to go. They're probably wanting to get on with
it. They were in the middle of shooting a TikTok day. Right,
they're like, okay girl, smile. They're probably freezing.
Do you want to look at the dupes or do you want to move on?
No, let's just move on. If we can scroll up and get a full okay, we already version got this one of Kaitlyn's look. And I included for these looks shoes too, if we did get a sneak peek of shoes. I normally don't include shoes on the blog, but she was just wearing a cute little gold sandal. So I did attach some gold sandal options and I found some good prices. But you can keep scrolling
and
up.
And for the new people, these are all, you can click on each one of these and order them, and Tasha gets affiliate sales. So these are functional. You can, if you like this, click on
it. If you buy
it.
One of these things, I might get a buck. So
a dollar, folks. Hey, somebody did. They called in and they bought a few things here.
That's really sweet.
You made a small coffee at Starbucks.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, it's, I mean, I do this for fun, and I do this because you guys have given me so much like positive feedback doing these videos and on the blog posts. So, you know, it's for fun, but it is nice to get a little tip in the tip jar. We appreciate it.
A little bread in the tip jar for Tasha.
So everybody loved this dress on Katie. There was so much chatter about how beautiful she looks. She looks so great in this emerald green. We were seeing a lot of green from her this season, and it really does suit her. Like the color, the tones just really suit her. Yeah, her skin tone.
Just a brunette, green and brunette go well together, or does it just work for her?
You know, I don't know. Tone? And she did various shades of green too. I mean, if you think back from the beginning, we've seen a lot of greens on her, from like very limey to very emerald to very bright. And this one has like, you know, more teal hues. But I just love this look on her. There's a lot going on in this dress, so we'll just briefly touch on the points that like stood out to me. So it's got high bust point here. I guess I'm kind of blanking on like what the actual words, like strap join. The strap join on the top of the cups is really high here. Typically, it's closer to the collarbone, like closer to the top of her shoulders. I feel like on most dresses, it would be closer to her bust with a longer strap showing. But this has like the bust shape going higher, which just showing a little bit of strap.
It gives it like some toga, like a toga feel to it, kind of like, you know, it's like a toga would be clasped at the top.
Yeah,
there.
Or it would have a little wrap detail or something. And then we have the plunging deep V. But because the dress, the bodice and the skirt are joined at her natural waist, because this strap joint is so high, we're really getting like a very extended, long looking deep V without it going like way below her belly button, like J-Lo style.
Would you call her she's a full blown celebrity in this?
Yeah, absolutely. Katie Thurston, congratulations. Carpet vibes. This is so beautiful. I mean, obviously, this is her engagement day. She wants to look like $1 million bucks.
She brought out the winner. This was waiting in the back of the closet for a special day. I know Tasha's got some of those dresses. When you need to make someone feel jealous, you pull the dress out. It makes a noise.
Is that what's happening?
Yeah, for sure.
But anyway, a couple other things to note. So it does have the little mesh inset at the center front and below the armholes, because if you see, the armholes are also cut in a deep V, and then it's open back. She's got the slit.
But do you think it came like that, or do you think they altered it for like ABC? Because obviously, they've done some of that where they
this is pretty typical. Lots of designers use this in this dress. You do see this a lot in gowns. Could they potentially have added in the mesh? Sure,
because as you pointed out, they were doing that with Claire. They were like adding extra coverage to Claire back in the day. I think that's
Claire or Tayshia maybe. Remember, but I don't remember the specifics, but yeah, that you will see from time to time, if you're looking closely on the show, where they will do a little bit of altering on some of the looks that they're picking out for their bachelorettes. And you know, that might just be typical tailoring. A lot of times when you have, especially if you're getting like a very, very expensive custom gown, or if you're working with the designer, like if the stylist on the show has a close connection with the designer and has spoken to the designer and says, hey, you know, I think our bachelorette this season is going to look really great in a lot of your looks. Could you custom make a few pieces for me? You know, that kind of stuff it wouldn't surprise me that that happens, that maybe they're sending the designer the bachelorette's measurements and asking for something to be custom made. And maybe they're also putting in some special requests, like, can we make this slightly more modest? And then maybe the designer or the stylist accommodates with a little bit of tailoring.
Well, you don't think of this too often, but time is money on set. I mean, there's dozens of people working. If they have a wardrobe problem, they can't continue filming. They need to like solve that, you know?
I would say they probably pick all of these items out in advance. Like you were saying, she may have seen this dress in a fitting early on in the season and said, I'm saving that for proposal day.
Yeah, they know that you gets know, a little more formal.
I think they do fittings at the beginning. They pick out their favorite looks that they like. They pick out what their overall vibe is going to be. And maybe that's why she wore a lot of red and a lot of green on the show this season. Because, you know, that's what she was initially drawn to. But anyway, lovely. Love the high slit in the front. We had a really, really long train. I mean, you can see it sitting on the ground in that photo. You know, it drug on the ground when she walked. It looked super heavy, which means it's probably very, very expensive. But yeah, she just looked so stunning in this dress.
So you don't think this is from Shein? This isn't a Shein dress?
I don't think this one is from Shein. But yeah, so I included some things that I thought were close. If you want to check out any of these looks, they kind of range from like emerald and forest green to teal. But teal's I was really fun. Just trying to stick to like V-necks, tiny straps, full-length gowns. And there's a few different options in there.
Very nice.
Thanks, babe.
Which one's your favorite here? This one's great.
I think middle, actually right? This, if you go back up, the cheapest option that I have linked right there, that $88 version, I think that really does a nice job of kind of hitting the same notes as the dress.
The cheapest option is your favorite. You must be sick. Are you okay? Are you warm? Oh my gosh.
We'll zoom out. I can decide if I linked some other ones. I did this dress a few days ago.
They're all pretty decently priced for a nice evening dress. Yeah, they are. They're
really nice. The Reformation one is really pretty too.
We get into the $400, but. All right, nice.
But anyway, if we want to keep on scrolling, we've got moves to make. Oh, you know what? Can you scroll down to the bottom of this episode? Just below the very first look that... Keep going.
Down?
Yep. We talked about the little shoulder pad t-shirt, but also right before she was getting dressed. Yep. Oh, we missed one. We missed her little white dress from date night with Blake.
Oh,
it was really cute. The jacket was really cute too, actually. I was in love with the jacket when she first came out. And I think it might have been, I don't know if it's the same jacket that we saw earlier in the season. It might be the same, might be a different one, but they did it. It seems like she wore a couple different white and light gray kind of oversized wool coats. But this is really beautiful. The dress itself is a white mini dress with like either rhinestone or crystal detailing on the straps. It had spaghetti straps that had crystal detailing, and then the center front had three little crystal straps across this deep V. So I was just, you know, I linked some things that were kind of close. Nothing's exactly the same, but I was really looking for the crystal detailing on the straps. Now back to what
Keep going down.
Yep.
Farther.
The last thing. I love this.
This is the last one of this video?
This is the last one of the actual episode, and then we'll talk about the looks from after the final rose. So when she was getting dressed for the proposal, they were following her around in her hotel room, and she had on this beautiful robe, and I'm so obsessed with it.
Love a good robe.
I love a robe. Dave knows I love a robe. I love a cozy robe. I love a fluffy robe. I love a terry cloth robe. I love a silk robe.
Multiple robes.
She likes to
double pop collar her robes. No one's getting to me tonight.
So I last minute went ahead and added this in. Obviously, I didn't get a great screenshot, but that's okay.
You know I hate robes, too. Not on you, on myself. You know I hate robes on myself.
I love a robe. How else do you want to walk around your house in the middle of the day? I want fluffy slippers and a nice silky robe or a cozy robe if it's wintertime. Anyway, I love this one.
You should design your own robes. You should be a robe designer. I'm sure the audience will buy it. Leave a comment. Would you buy one of Tasha's robes? Let us know. We'll start a business.
I am not opposed to this idea at all. I would absolutely design some killer robes.
You got to get a little pocket for the controller.
I'm going to start with 100% silk, though.
Okay. All right. Silk robes. You heard it here first, folks.
Okay. But anyway, so I love this. It's got very much bridal vibes, which was right on point for proposal day. I love the white with the floral pattern. So I just did a quick search for some floral print robes, and I found some really great options. So this first one that I have listed, I actually think is the best of the ones that I linked, the 29 floral tassel robe. And I want to say it's from Birdie Gray. Now, the white one is currently unavailable, but it's restocking soon. So you can be notified when it's back in stock. They did have a bunch of other colors. They had blue ground, pink ground, orange ground. I don't know. They had a bunch of other colors, but I thought the white just looked so similar to the one that Katie's wearing.
Yeah.
But if you click on that, you can put yourself on the wait list or whatever and get notified when it comes back in stock, which will hopefully be very soon, because for $29, I would like one too. Anyway,
you all got right. So much space in that closet. You can totally afford it. You couldn't put an ankle sock in there. You couldn't put one of Justin's nude socks in there. He had those nice nude socks we didn't cover, but no one cares about those.
Oh, yeah, he had little
nice old ankle socks. All right, so where are we going? Back up?
Let's go back up to After the Final Rose. So we just have our three dresses from After the Final Rose left to talk about.
This one?
Here we go, Tayshia. I love this. I love what Tayshia wears.
Yeah, I'm a Kaitlyn fan.
Well, anyway, everybody does a good job, but this was really, really cute. It's super like intergalactic. New I love Year's. That they have the floor lit up in purple, because this is giving me like, what is it? Xenon Girl of the 21st Century vibes. Like,
there you go.
Yeah, like it is very like futuristic and spacey. But it's just, you know, a green little, silver little sparkly, glittery kind of dress. It has a little twist tie detailing at the waist on the side, which gives it a little bit of added dimension. She's doing the strapless thing. It's form fitting. This is fun. It's cute. Yeah, you're right.
It's
like
good.
This is a great New Year's dress, but there's a bunch of other occasions that you could totally wear something like this for. So I linked a bunch of
Star Trek convention, maybe. It's just kind of, it's very like NASA sexy. You know?
So I linked a bunch of silver dresses. Some of them are sequins, some of them are glitter, some of them are just a shiny, shimmery fabric. But I was really going for bodycon, strapless if they had it, or little skinny straps. And I think I found some really fun options. So if you feel like trying out a silver dress for a little girl's night out coming up, here's where to do it.
Yeah, put the ass
in
the
astronaut. Shoes as well. Oh, by the way, so the shoes, the actual shoes that she's wearing are Jimmy Choo's. And there were three, the actual ones that she's wearing, I'm not sure if I was able to get them exactly. So they have the clear toe. It's like the plasticky clear toe.
Doesn't look comfortable at all.
But I love the like rhinestone embellished detail at the strap across the front of the foot. I just thought that was so pretty. So I did link three close versions of this Jimmy Choo. They're all the same style of shoe, but one of them had like a silver toe. I think one had a mesh or a clear toe. I can't remember exactly. I linked three of them because they were really, really cute.
Be comfortable. I mean, you must have to go to the chiropractor.
Who needs to be comfortable when you look like that?
All right. Good point.
All right.
Solid point. Should we go up to Kaitlyn?
No, I just want to show the shoes that I linked real quick. If you scroll down,
oh,
I did
you.
Link some silver shoes.
Oh, nice.
So I was really going for the sort of crystal embellished strap across the foot, because I thought that was like the really extra fun part about this shoe. I linked a couple other options.
$875.
You know, some things that were close. Well, yeah.
I
normally don't want to link the very expensive stuff.
Yeah,
but,
live your life.
You know, kind of when I'm getting going, I just am clicking anything that looks similar. And then sometimes I get, you know, 16 pairs deep and I try to eliminate, but
nice.
Oh, and actually, by the way, now that you've got that Nine West one on the screen. So I think the shoes that Tayshia's wearing, they're actually not clear crystal embellishments. I think they are slightly rainbow toned. But you can't tell obviously because she's on a purple lit floor in a studio.
Who knew?
But if you click the link to the actual Jimmy Choo's, you'll see that there are some sort of rainbowy crystal in the strap. So I did link that. What was that? Nine West? I don't remember. It doesn't matter. You
okay.
Can scroll up. You guys, if you want to see, you can check it out for yourself.
More color happening here.
Yes.
With Tayshia.
Here we are.
I'm Kaitlyn,
for
sorry.
Kaitlyn's look. She did the same shimmery vibe. When I first saw the promo pics of this, I thought this was another like faux leather look, but then you could tell in the episode that it actually was just a shimmery look like Tayshia. So it's a shimmery pink fabric. And it's really reading the same as what Tayshia's wearing. Tayshia had the little knot, the little twist tie detail on the side, like at the princess point on her dress. And Kaitlyn's has the shearing just all the way across. So she's got shearing at the side seams, which is giving these lines, this dimension across her body.
A lot can change in a season. Started out not engaged and now is engaged. So
Kaitlyn?
Yeah, a lot of love happening across the board here.
And her dress actually has straps. It has little black kind of thick, maybe half inch spaghetti straps. We can't see it with her hair showing right here. But I did link some similar looks. I was just going for fun, pink, shimmery, shearing.
Very fun.
So yeah, another little pleathery look. So yeah, lots of cute options there. And then she's wearing really cute shimmery pink shoes, little strappy shoes as well. So I just linked some fun pink shoes that give similar vibes.
I think this will be, this is like you're going out in Ibiza, put some color on, turn some necks. What do I know? But this looks like a lot of fun.
Yeah. Really cute options.
All right. So they clearly were having a good time. And then, of course, the lady of the hour here.
In white, because she is engaged now.
Yeah. You know, I actually have some music for that. So if we want to talk about this, I know you can't hear it, but I got Canon and D. Should I play Canon and D?
Is that really what you want to
do? Yeah, we got Canon and D, folks. All right. Now tell us what we got working here.
All right, so her dress is really cute, mini dress, bodycon. It's got the high neck and a sort of racer cutout shoulder here. It's got the skinny shoulder straps close to the neck and the nice shape at the front of her arm. It looks really great because obviously she's like very athletic. It looks very nice on her. And then it's got either a sequin or beading detailing in silver at the neckline and then the little squiggly zigzags all down the front. This is a great look. I mean, it's simple, but it's beautiful. It goes with the other girls. Like, it's very bridal. Like, this is definitely, like, announcing our engagement vibes. Like, this is perfect for the night.
Show stealer.
Yeah. She looks like $1 million. And this is not, like, trying too hard. This is not overdoing it. This is, like, a more subdued engagement announcement dress. And I really like it. I think she looks great. I linked some similar shaped dresses, minis, bodycon, with some embellishment details. So if you're looking for something similar, I do have it. And then I linked some shoes that look similar to her shoes as well. And her shoes were pretty basic. They were just a strappy little heel, but I was looking for strappy detailing on nude or white heels.
Great.
Yeah.
Does this wrap it up? I mean, does this wrap the season up for you?
I mean,
where do you go from here?
I definitely didn't talk about all the episodes on the show. I mean, all of the outfits on tonight's episode on the show, but I feel like we hit all the important stuff.
This is what we refer to as doing the Lord's work here, Tasha Marie. So I really did a great job. Your first season doing Tasha's take, I think you really knocked it out of the park.
Leave a comment for Tasha here. We did it. We stuck with it.
Time flies. I know, right?
Yeah, we stuck with it. Really fast. I can't believe that this is our last episode. I'm sad, but I'm looking forward to recapping Michelle's season.
So, oh yeah, she's gonna be great.
Yeah, I'm excited. I feel like we didn't really get to see too much of her personal style on the last season, on Matt's season.
She's sporty, but then she has like the teacher sort of conservative, but she's like very athletic. She's got a good look.
You know what? I would love to see some like really classic teacher looks on her because she teaches elementary, right?
She did.
Like I want to see her in like a jean like. Little like overall jumper with like a super colorful sweater underneath.
Was she in Catholic school?
No. I want to see like 90s elementary school vibes. That would be real. That's just me. Maybe that's just what I want in my closet right now because it's very on trend.
You got no space. Well, look, people can go follow you for your wardrobe and fashion advice. You're posting content on Instagram every day at Tasha Courtney. So don't delay. Go follow Tasha today. And then I think you got to start covering. There's so much happening in Bachelor Nation. There actually is some pretty good forward trending fashion. Is that even a term? You know, there's a lot of fashion happening out there. So
yeah, definitely. I mean, some of these really fashionable girls, I see cute outfits on their Instagrams. I can try and do a little more of that if that's what the people want.
What do you want, folks? Leave a comment. Let us know.
And I might try and touch on to Bachelor in Paradise from time to time, but I haven't figured out if I'm going to have time to do a Tasha's take for every episode of Bachelor in Paradise. I'm not sure. But yeah. We'll think about it.
Well, anyway, it's been a fun time collaborating with you, Tasha, and I really enjoyed this process. I like that we get to enjoy the screen together.
Yeah, it's fun.
All right. Is this a wrap on the season for you?
I guess this is a wrap on the season. Oh, how sad. It's so hard to say goodbye. Well, thank you everybody for watching all season long. I hope you had a little fun. I hope you found some value in what I'm talking about. But most of all, thank you so much for being here. It's been fun for me. I think it's been fun and maybe just a little bit stressful.
We've learned so much. So thank you so much, Tasha.
But hopefully we will see you next time.
Bye, everybody.